like to invite Professor K. Purushottam Reddy to occupy his position. Professor K. Purushottam Reddy is a former Deputy of Political Science, Osmania University, and the Osmania University Teachers Association President.
I'll begin. Professor Purushottam Reddy and Dean Chalamaya. Lakshmaya. Professor Lakshmaya, he wears so many hats and he's just an extraordinary person. I cannot reciprocate the comments you have given to me, sir, but I sincerely appreciate your generous version of Farooq Ali Khan. Maybe with the exception of one, I hope I get to be as great as Mr. Lakshmaya thinks. I'm attempting. So I'm just an ordinary, humble servant of mankind, an activist, peace activist. And you have already heard about our chief guest, Mr. Huda, a fine young man at such an early age. When he came and said, I thought he was from Afghanistan too. Very much impressed with his bio. I'm very fortunate that I was able to meet him. And of course, Professor Venugopal, he's an intellectual among intellectuals too. We have heard the introduction by Professor Lakshmaya. So I will not be able to go into that. But let me say, first of all, I'll talk about the biryani later for 1 second. He reminded me of something our chief guest. But congratulations to the batch of 2011. And I had to struggle. I had tremendous challenges, but that's what the power of education is. It prepares us to meet those challenges. It's extremely critical that we not only enjoy what we have achieved, but we have to remember what power it has given it to us. I'm sure I can sense the energy in this hall. I'm delighted. I'm delighted. And I'm so proud of the students from Afghanistan. Etc., etc., so on and so forth. Indeed, this is an international body. Let me also recognize President Khushan. He's a fine young man. Remember, Napoleon was. Khushan, remember, Napoleon was also not a huge man, but he had taken the whole world. So, and of course, Professor Lakshmaya understands that. So, with that, I think in the future to come, you'll become great ambassadors like Professor Venugopal said, to borrow a line from him. And it will strengthen the ties between our countries. It's extremely important that as students, as educated graduates from the illustrious University of Osmania University, and I think that the congratulations goes not only to you, the grads, but also to the faculty and administration of Osmania University, who have worked very, very hard to get you prepared to face the world and the challenges. And at the same time, I think it is very important to recognize your parents. Your mom and dad, your grandparents and your great-grandparents. What we are today, it did not happen overnight. Like at one time I said 2 years ago, talking to the students from Osmania University and engineering, and it was Ravindra Bandhi was full of students, and my good friend Purushottam Reddy, I owe him everything in this town, seriously, for bringing me out of the kind of atmosphere I was living in this town. dealing with personal issues. And he has really created a stimulus in my brain, and he's responsible for my being here. So I said when Mr. Rahul Gandhi was there, and I talked to the students, and I talked about the fear of politics, and how religions of the world are being used to create distrust and problems among us. So we are all one, remember one thing, and do not allow. I don't want you to ever allow religion to be. Remember, the entire world is going through a tremendous change. Look at the world a couple hundred years ago. We can imagine. And where we are today. And things are happening at a lightning speed. Things are changing so fast. Like as I said to the Kenyan students, where my good friend Purushottam Reddy was there, Professor Reddy. I lovingly call him Pushu sometimes. At the snap of a finger, industries are moving from one area to another part of the world. Click of a button. So the entire economy is a global economy now. So we cannot say, when Kushan and I had a couple of meetings, and I had the opportunity when I was at Governor State University, a very obscure university, a state-funded university, an accredited university, but it was an inexpensive university to form ISA, which stood for International Students Association. I was a founder and president in 1972 or 73, because I sensed at the time the students need, and I changed instead of foreign students, I said international students. Because to me that was very important, because in a country like America, a great country, where you can go, and you once you become a naturalized citizen or permanent resident, you can call yourself an American. Nowhere in the world you can say that. If you go to Germany, if you go to France, if you go to Italy, or if you go to China or any part of the world, maybe with the exception of India, yes, because at one time we were all one together. So it's very critical that our minds have to be at a global level, and the global economy to participate. And remember, my friends, my young friends, please, for God's sake, remember. Languages are wonderful and beautiful. Don't get me wrong. India has a huge stash or treasure of languages and cultures. Sort of at ease, they know what is happening over there. Son of a Muslim father, of course with a name like Barack Hussein Obama, and a son of a Christian mother, raised Christian, accepted Christianity, that's the freedom. So I'm very happy that he was able to move forward and he got elected. And it's very important, I was just asked to finish. And I think I will not finish until the job is done. Unless until you graduates want me to finish. Without hearing that biryani joke. You want to hear the biryani joke? Yes. Mr. Huda reminded me, a friend of mine was visiting Middle East. He was a software engineer. So he was put up in a very nice hotel. So at around midnight, he went downstairs and said, let's take a little swim. Because nobody was there when he was coming up. When he went upstairs, but let me thank you on behalf of the Subedar Gandhi Foundation for allowing me to be here. It's a great honor and it's a privilege, seriously. And I want to congratulate you and on your accomplishment. And I wish you nothing but the best. And God willing, you will do fine. And God willing, peace will come to our regions and everywhere. So take care of yourself, take care of your families, and remember all those who made it possible for you to